assembly language program to display string Ganesh on 16x2 LCD using 8051. So according to the flowchart discussed in last video lecture, we will write a program to display this string on 16x2 LCD display. So we'll start with a main program, and in main program first we have to send command to LCD. That means we have to write commands in LCD command register. So first command is 38H, that will stored in accumulator. Command is to select 16x2 LCD with 5x7 dot matrix pattern for display of character. So 38H command is stored in accumulator, and we will call a command subroutine. The name of command subroutine is LCD underscore command. So this command will be written in command register. The next command we have to write in command register is 0EH, that is cursor on display on. So to write this command, again we will call subroutine program LCD underscore command. Next command we want to write is 01H, that is clear display. So we'll store it in accumulator and again call LCD command. So these three commands we are going to use for initialization of LCD. And if we want to display the string at one particular character position, then we can use command for that. For example, suppose I want to write this Ganesh string or display Ganesh string from character whose address is 82H, then I have to store this address in accumulator, and then I will call again LCD command. So the starting first character of string will be displayed from character address 82H on LCD. Now after this, to display a string we have to first point this DPTR register to a string lookup table. So we'll give name to lookup table as string. So the address of first character of string of lookup table is stored in DPTR register. Now we'll initialize this accumulator 00H, and we'll use instruction move C, that is move data or read data from memory location. So at A plus DPTR. So DPTR is having address of first character of string and accumulator is initialized to 0. So this instruction will read data from this particular address and store the data in accumulator. So data is in accumulator, and next step is we have to check whether contents of accumulator are 0 or not, to check whether this is end of string or not. So for that we'll use instruction jump 0 and we'll jump to exit label. So jump if accumulator contents are 0 to label exit. If it is not end of the string, we'll call subroutine program LCD underscore data. So the accumulator content, that is ASCII value of character, will be written in data register, and that character will be displayed on LCD display. So after displaying one character, now we want to increment this DPTR. So it will point to next character of string. So increment DPTR and S jump. After incrementing, repeat the process. So I'll give here label back. So back label we have to give to this instruction. that is again initialize accumulator to 0, then exit, and then write this ASCII value in data register, increment DPTR for next character, and continue this operation. But if data stored in accumulator is 0, then we'll go to loop or label exit. So here we want to stop program, so I'll write here S jump exit. So controller will continuously execute this instruction, so that means it will stop execution. LCD underscore command. So before writing subroutine program, we can call delay. So we'll write a simple delay program and call that delay program with name delay. Then next step is, whatever command is stored in accumulator in main program, for example 38H is stored in accumulator and we are calling this subroutine. So here 38H is available in accumulator, we'll place the data of accumulator, which is command now, on data bus, so that is P2, on P2 port. After that we have to clear RS register to select command register. So P0.5 is connected to RS, so here you can write comment RS is equal to 0, register select terminal is 0, so command register is selected. Next step is, we want to perform write operation, so P0.6, which is connected to R/W pin, so that should be 0, so R/W is equal to 0, so that's why we have used clear instruction to make these pins 0. Now next step is, send enable signal as high to low pulse. So for that, first we'll use instruction set bit P0.7, which will say make this enable terminal 1, and immediately we will clear this terminal. So clear P0.7. So now enable terminal is at logic 0. If you want, you can call a delay between these two pulses, or without delay also it will work. So after this, we want to return to main program to write a next command or to send a data. So last instruction of this subroutine should be return instruction. So first we'll write main program, then command subroutine program, and below this command subroutine program we will write data subroutine, that is LCD underscore data. So same steps we have to repeat here. First we'll call a small delay, so call a delay subroutine, then move the data which is in accumulator, that is placed on data bus, that is port P2. Then the RS register should be at logic 1, so we'll use command, we will use instruction set bit P0.5, so that is RS is equal to 1, so data register is selected. After that, clear P0.6, that means we are performing write operation, so R/W bar pin of LCD should be at logic 0. Next step is to send high to low enable pulse, so again we'll use set bit P0.7 and clear P0.7. So again we are sending high to low pulse on enable terminal. This process will write data in data register and the character will be displayed on LCD. So last instruction always should be RET instruction. So we'll write RET instruction. So we have written main program, then command subroutine program, then data subroutine program, and now since we are using delay subroutine, we have to write short delay program. So we'll write here delay program. Just use two instructions, two registers to store delay. I'll use here maximum count FFH. Then I'll use second register R1. Again, it will be initialized to FFH. Then I'll use here DJNZ jump not equal to 0. Register R1 to L2. So continuously execute this instruction till R1 becomes 0, and after that use instruction DJNZ R0 L1. I'll give L1 label here, which will generate a maximum delay using two register, and last instruction is return. After this, the important thing is remaining, that is write a string. So here we'll write string with name string db, which indicates each character ASCII value is of 8 bit, and then whatever string you want to display, that can be written here with 0 to indicate end of character.